Hello friends, welcome to our literary channel Academic Domain. Today I am going to discuss about Edmund Spenser, about his life and works. So while talking about Edmund Spenser, there will be so many points which will be relevant for the exams of NET, CTET and JRF. And friends, if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, please subscribe it and press the bell icon to get notified my new videos. Please like, share and give your valuable feedback so that I can do better in my next videos. So this is our poet, Edmund Spenser. Edmund Spenser was born in 1552-53, died in 1599, was one of the greatest English poets. Actually, the year of birth is not confirmed about Edmund Spenser. That's why 52 and 53 both are mentioned here. His father John Spenser was a journeyman and cloth maker. As a young boy, he was educated in London at the Merchant Tailors School and matriculated as a sizer at Pembroke College, Cambridge. So here, sizer means a poor student who serves other students for his educational expenses. So it means that we can understand that how poor Edmund Spenser's family was, that they were not able to afford his educational expenses. In July 1580, Spenser went to Ireland in service of the newly appointed Lord Deputy Arthur Grey, 14th Baron Grey de Wilton. When Lord Grey was recalled to England, Spenser stayed on in Ireland, having acquired other official posts and lands in the Munster plantation. In 1598, during the Nine Years' War was fought between Ireland and England. So in 1598, during the 9 Years' War, Spenser was driven from his home by the native Irish forces of Ord O'Neill. His castle at Kilcolman was burned, and Ben Jonson, who may have had private information, asserted that one of his infant children died in the ablaze. After being driven from his home in 1599, Spenser traveled to London, where he died at the age of 46. His coffin was carried to his grave in Poets' Corner in Westminster Abbey by other poets, who threw many pens and pieces of poetry into his grave with many tears. So it was about Edmund Spenser. Now we will discuss about his works here. In 1579, the Shepherd's Calendar was published. This was the first poetic work by Edmund Spenser, which was published in 1579 under the pseudonym Emerito. So first work he published under the pen name Emerito. Fairy Queen is the another work, a very important work by Edmund Spenser. It's an epic poem and fantastical allegory celebrating the Tudor dynasty and Elizabeth I. So actually, Fairy Queen contains 6 books. So first 3 books were published in 1590 and second 3 books were published in 1596. 1595, Amority and Epithalamion. So it is another very important poetic collection of Edmund Spenser, which was published in 1595. It includes sequence of 89 sonnets along with a series of short poems called Anacreontics and Epithalamion, a public poetic celebration of his marriage with Elizabeth Boyle. So in this collection, Amority and Epithalamion, there are 89 sonnets and some short poems. Those poems are called as Anacreontics. And one more narrative poem was published in that collection, that is known as Epithalamion, which is composed on the occasion of his own marriage with Elizabeth Boyle. His other works like Complaints, the full title is Complaints Containing Sundry Small Poems of the World's Vanity. So this is the full title of the poem of the collection, but in short it is known as Complaints, which was published in 1591. So the other important work by Edmund Spenser is Estrophil. The full title is Estrophil, a pastoral elegy upon the death of the most noble and valorous knight, Sir Philip Sidney. So this is the full title of the poem of the work, but in short it is known as Estrophil, which was published in 1595. His other poetic work is Colin Clouds Come Home Again. It is a pastoral poem which was published in 1595. And his other work is Prothalamium. The full title of the poem is Prothalamium, or Espousal Verse in Honor of the Double Marriage of Lady Elizabeth and Lady Catherine Somerset. It is a nuptial song on the occasion of the twin marriage of the daughters of the Earl of Worcester, and those daughters were Elizabeth Somerset and Catherine Somerset, and their marriage happened with Henry Guildford and William Peter. So this is another narrative poem by Edmund Spenser, which was published in 1596.